An ideal diesel cycle has a cutoff ratio of 1.8 and a compression ratio of 18. It takes air at 85 kPa and 280 Kelvin. What is the thermal efficiency of this cycle? As usual, try pausing here for a minute and solve this yourself before watching the solution up next. This is the first example for the diesel cycle main lecture. The link to that 10-minute lecture and the links to all the other lectures of the thermal course are found in the description below. The thermal efficiency of a diesel cycle is the same as any of the gas power cycles. The efficiency is the fraction of the energy coming in that we can actually use as work. What's coming in is heat in from the combustion, and the usable work is going to be the difference between the heat in and the heat out, at least ideally. This means we need to calculate the heat in, which we learned in the main lecture is the enthalpy change between 3 and 2, and we need to calculate the heat out, which is still isochoric heat removal, or the internal energy change between 4 and 1. This is assuming state 1 as the state before the compression stage. Now, since the working fluid here is air, we know that we can calculate these four values if we have the temperatures. Since T1 was given, we can just look up U1 for T1 in our tables. For T2, we know that the compression process is assumed to be isentropic. And since we have the compression ratio, or V1 over V2, we know we can use relative volumes to find T2. T2 is whatever temperature corresponds to VR2. And since V2 over V1 is equal to VR2 over VR1, all we need to find is VR1 to calculate VR2. Therefore, we look up VR1 for the T1 value we got, we substitute it in the relative volumes expression to find VR2, and we find the T2 that corresponds to VR2 by interpolating. We don't really need T2 for the heat calculation, but we'll still use it in the next step. What we need is the enthalpy though. So we just interpolate from VR2 to find H2. From 2 to 3, we have isobaric heat addition. Since air is an ideal gas, we can solve for T3, and since it's isobaric, P's cancel out. With T2 and the cutoff ratio, we calculate T3. And with T3, we go to the table and interpolate to find H3. And finally, between 3 and 4, we have an isentropic expansion. So we can use relative volumes again. The difference here is we don't directly have V4 over V3. But it's an easy calculation. The ratio V4 over V3 can be written as V4 over V2, which is the compression ratio, times V2 over V3, which is the reciprocal of the cutoff ratio. We interpolate for VR3 with T3, which gives us VR4, and with it, we look up the internal energy value that corresponds to it, U4. We now substitute all specific energy values to find the two heat values, and we substitute these to find the efficiency of this diesel cycle as a decimal. We can multiply by 100 to show it as a percentage. If you want to check out other diesel cycle examples, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermal course, as well as the other engineering courses playlists. Thanks for watching!